Hello and welcome to the Non-League Show. Today we're at the Bibby Financial Services Stadium for Worthing versus Enfield Town. Now the sun is in the air, it's the first day of spring and both teams need to bounce back from disappointing midweek defeats. Worthing lost 1-0 away at lowly Sudbury and Enfield Town were on the reverse of a 3-0 drubbing at the hands of promotion chasing Tunbridge Angels. Now both teams have struggled for consistency in the league this season and that's what they need to put right going forward. One thing we are guaranteed today, though, is goals. Worthing have averaged nearly 4 goals a game in games they've been involved in this season in the league and also haven't featured in one 0-0 draw at all this season. It's going to be a cracker. Stay tuned and find out. So I'm here with Worthing fan Edward. Edward, so you're a newly found Worthing supporter.
Yeah, I am.
And how are you enjoying it so far this season?
Good. It's been absolutely fantastic, actually, so have. I've really enjoyed it.
And what's encouraged you to suddenly come down and support Worthing?
My grandson wanted to come down, and so I said I'll take him down and watch the football, and I've really enjoyed it since then.
What's been the highlight for you in the past 6 months?
The goals. There've been some great goals to have, and some great saves as well from both sides, you know, Worthing and the play. And it's a really good set-up and all here. You know, very friendly club and that. Very good.
Brilliant stuff. And last but not least, I can't let you go without making a prediction on today's game. Two teams chasing for the playoffs. What do you reckon the score is going to be?
Well, hoping Worthing will win 2-1.
Brilliant stuff. All right, well, thanks very much, Edward. Enjoy the game.
And you too.
Cheers. Bye-bye. Bye. So I'm here with three young Worthing supporters, Dan, Charlie and Isla. How old are you guys? 11. So what are you doing coming down to Worthing on a Saturday afternoon?
I don't know. I just want to watch the game.
Want to watch the game. So do you come and watch Worthing whenever you can?
I mostly go to every match because the goalkeeper is my best friend's brother.
Oh, spot on. And is this the first year you've been coming down to watch Worthing?
Yeah.
And do you enjoy it?
Yeah.
What's your favourite part about coming down to the ground on a match day?
The start with sometimes I just play football with my mates in the back and then we watch the game and watch them practice as we are right now.
Awesome stuff. And I'm going to ask you, what do you reckon the score is going to be today?
2-1.
2-1.
2-3.
2-3, so you think we're going to lose?
3-2.
3-2 to Worthing. So a mixed bag of predictions here from our young fans who enjoy their day at the Bibby Financial Services Stadium. Team news coming up shortly.
Welcome to the Bibby Financial Services Stadium once again for this afternoon's Ryman Premiership game against Enfield Town.
So just ahead of today's game, we'll go through the two teams, starting with the home team, Worthing. In goal, number one, Kieran Thorpe, making his debut after signing just yesterday from Three Bridges. Number two, Matt Boiling. Number three, Sam Rents. Number four, Captain Kane Wills. Number five, Gary Elphick. Number six, Corey Heath. Number seven, Lloyd Dawes. Number eight, Brannan O'Neill. Number nine, making his home debut today, David Ajiboy. Number 10, Louis Clark. And number 11, Harvey Sparks. The substitutes for Worthing: Jack Cook, Ethan Bellwood, Aaron Hopkinson, Luke Brody and Reese Hallard. And for our visitors today, Enfield Town, in goal, captain number one, Nathan McDonald. Number two, Jonathan Maluba. Number three, Ricky Gabriel. Number four, Joseph Harold. Number five, Matt Kirby. Number six, Scott Shelton. Number seven, Tyler Campbell. Number eight, Billy Crook. Number nine, Bobby Devin. Number 10, Carl Olliede. And number 11, Mickey Parcell. And the substitutes for Enfield Town, Samir Biamontin, Nigel Nita. Number 15, Percy Kilenga-Benny. Number 16, Nathan Livings. And number 17, Donnell Winter. Worthing will be playing in their traditional red kits, kicking from left to right, and Enfield will take the kickoff wearing yellow shirts and blue shorts. Leeston is the team that they're chasing, currently occupying the last of the four playoff places. Devin are going to send away in the traditional two-man kickoff. And immediately straight on the attack there with Crook, but he loses out. And the first touch for Dobson Ajiboy. He runs into trouble. And Shelton, his pass was intercepted. Campbell with the ball in the middle of the park. Important play there from Sparks. Both teams struggling to hold on possession early on. And eventually it's worked all the way back to the keeper and captain for the day, McDonald. It's long over on the far side. Maliba tried to make something of it, and that's a high loose pass from Harold. O'Neill lost it in the middle there, and Sparks will get that clear. Such a big turnaround and change for Worthing in the goalkeeping department, with Kieran Thorpe making his debut today as he signed yesterday from Three Bridges as Worthing go on the attack. A lovely little turn of pace there from Clark. He gets his cross in, and it has to be put behind by Gabriel and stopped from going away by the goalkeeper. There's room for the new signing, Louis Clark. Important header in the air from Rents. And Harold with the ball at the back, it goes long. Devin was beaten in the air by captain, or by Gary Elphick, of course joint manager, along with John Meaney. Harold with time at the back, just inside their own half. Important pass forward from Shelton. It's picked up here by Ollie Eads. Worked it into the middle of the park and then fist out onto this left hand side with Gabriel, and he does well, set the ball back to Campbell with a little ball into the box. Important touch there from Ajiboy. Clearance only finds Campbell, and now Gabriel takes on his man. It's brought down, and a free kick in the corner for Enfield Town. Is headed away at the near post, picked up on the edge by Shelton. Nice pick off there from Clark. Dawes can't get on the end of it though, and Parcell just keeps the ball in play. He's got space to run forward. His low cross is easily dealt with, and Dawes can pick it up and maybe lead a break. He's got Ajiboy over on this near side, and then Wills plays it back to Boiling. A little chip over the ball looking for Ajiboy. He's not going to get on the end of that, so it comes back to Wills. Head out for Dawes, waited for it to bounce, and it was picked off by Crook. And Harold with a loose pass in the middle of the park, and ball through by O'Neill looking for Clark. Just didn't quite have enough on it. Time and space to pick out a pass. And eventually, good play from Devin. And now Ollie Eid. He turns. Ollie Eid on the edge area, gets into the area, gets his shot away. And it's wide of the upright. First shot of the game for Enfield Town. Dawes challenges in the air, wins it. Crook. Both players hesitant, and Dawes picks up on the mistake and shoots from distance, and McDonald grabs it at the second attempt. Thought looking early on the far side, and Sparks with a little touchdown. Good shepherding, but Sparks nearly made something off it. Goal kick. to this left-hand side with Gabriel. Back to Harrells. And across to Maliba. Pricks. Oh, lovely little dummy by Shelton. And here goes Maliba. He's gone into the area. He gets his cross in. And it's a chance and a great save. Fantastic save there from the debutant Thorpe. The danger's not over yet, though. Parcell, and then headed back safely by Boiling. It was Parcell who got his shot away from 6 yards. Thorpe with a great reaction save. Keeping the score level. Important header from Murphy, as your boy. Boiling. Goes up the line, held up by Dawes. He turns and goes, and still going, Dawes. He comes onto his left foot. He plays a lovely through. Clark is offside. Good positive play from first as your boy, and then Dawes and his little ball through for Clark. Good pressure, not allowing Worthing out of their last third. Clark, little flick touch, and Dawes was looking for that ball through, but still Clark battling against Kirby, and Howard's clearance rattles off Clark for a throw in to Enfield Town. Kirby. Now Harold at the back. It's a loose pass and Sparks picks it up and Clark takes on Harold. And Clark just gets into the box. He gets his cross. The keeper misses. Door's going to be. Oh, it's just wide in the upright. Clark got his cross in, and Dawes, when it bounced to him, you thought certainly he was going to add to his 19 goals this season, but it just went over the top and to the wide of the upright. Harold Elphick was there with an important challenge, but there's Shelton. Gabriel. Wills got a foot in, but it's still going to break to Devin. And there's Campbell. He gets his cross and it evades everyone. Kirby with the ball at the back. That's an important touch from Crook to Shelton. And pass out. And again, that's a loose pass, and Dawes picks the pocket of the fullback. And Dawes driving down the side. He's got Ajiboy just behind him. Dawes in the area. He finds Ajiboy. It comes for Clark. His shot was blocked. And now Crook can get it clear. Applause ringing round the Bibby Financial Services Stadium for that move and that determined play by Dawes. Kirby is allowed to bring the ball inside half and play over the top. And the keeper comfortably claims that one and throws it out to the fullback Boiling. It's a loose pass and Campbell. Nice flick round the corner from Crook, who gets it back from Molly Eade. And there's Crook. Returns, beats one man, goes for goal, and that's comfortable for the goalkeeper. But good initial footwork and play. Devin. Now Campbell. Nice ball out, and there's lots of space here for Gabriel. Gabriel into the area. Gets his shot away. It's a very important block by Elphick, and it will be a corner. Whipped in by Crooks, important header away from Rents, and then Ajiboy, but Shelton. Nice ball out for Crooks. This is a better cross, it's deep. Now free header, and it's hit the bar. And the ball cannons off Devin for a corner, but that was a real, real chance. So Maliba has just hit the bar, we'll take the throw in. Lead, couldn't win that one. And again, the ball is clear, that's easy for Harold. And there's space for Shelton, who evades the challenge and gets his shot away! And what a goal that is! 1-0 to Enfield Town. Shelton evaded the challenge of O'Neill and hit a delightful shot that swerved past the keeper into the corner. It's Worthing 0, Enfield Town 1. So Worthing get us underway with Wills back to Rents. They'll be looking for a quick response. We said we guarantee goals. Unfortunately, for the men in red, it's not always for them. They do have the worst defence outside the bottom four, but here comes Dawes. He tried to do a little bit too much, and Crooks picks his pocket. And Enfield look to capitalise with another goal very quickly, and there's lots of space over on this near side for Campbell, but the pass was loose. Jaboy will pick it up. I think playing around at the back, taking a risk, and Boiling. It's muscled off it by the goal scorer. Couldn't quite find Devin. Clark loses out. Crooks back to Harold. Again, there's lots of space over on this near side for Gabriel if they decide to switch. But for the moment, Parcell goes back to his goalkeeper. Important flick on and away from Elphick. So Shelton comes back to Horton Worthing again. He's the one that opened the scoring the last time these two teams met back at the Queen Elizabeth Stadium. And here is another run, an important run. Still Shelton was going. And eventually, it's defended by Rents. He gets it clear. Enfield Town with their towers up at the moment. Shelton. And the fullback maneuver has to go all the way back. It's looking for lead. Breaks for Devin. Parcell. The loose pass back, but Maliba will get there. Campbell in the middle of the park. Wills was trying to put the pressure on. The ball over the top, and that's a loose header from Boiling, and Gabriel's cross is then blocked by Boiling, who apologises to his goalkeeper, and it'll be another corner for Enfield Town. Corner's headed away at the near post by Sparks. Still the danger's not over, but Rents hooks the ball out for a throw-in. Gabriel. Elliot. Got a little push in the back from Boiling, but held onto the ball and fed it back to Harold. Crooks Good pressure from Sparks. There's three red shirts on your round, but Enfield play their way out of trouble. And Crooks brings it forward. The ball forward to Parcell. Then out to the fullback. It's Maliba. Space in the middle for Shelton. Instead, it's Parcell who takes over. And then uses Shelton. Feeds a lovely ball behind. And Ollie's ball nearly find Devon. And again, Worthing looked to go on the attack very quickly, and Dawes is beaten to it by Kirby. It's a little studs in challenge there. But Gabriel goes into here, gets a cross in. Well, that evades everyone. Shelton with Crooks. Harold. Enfield Town looking to come out with that little spill of Worthing pressure and just see out the half. It's Crooks. Space out here, and that indeed is the end of the first half. It's been thoroughly entertaining, and we've had the opening goal after Enfield Town had hit the bar with a header from the fullback Gabriel. It was Shelton who got the ball in the middle of the park, turned O'Neill, and then leashed a drive into the far corner. The half-time score is Worthing 0, Enfield Town 1. Second half. One thing that they may look to as a positive stat is they failed to score on Tuesday night against Sudbury. They haven't gone two games without a goal this season. And Kirby with a little slice ball, but fortunately for him, the fullback was there. Keith. And then Rents up for Ajiboy. He looks to be playing a little bit more centrally in the second half. Heath with Ollie Eads. Referee not interested in a free kick there. Rents up to Ajiboy. He loses out to yellow shirts around him. Crooks with space. There's Campbell. Over on the far side, going up against Boiling, going into the area, getting his cross, and he's broken in. It's a goal straight from kickoff, pretty much a goal. And this time it's Crook. A cross was it, took a slight deflection on its way through and then found unmarked from about 8 yards, the number 8 Billy Crook, and he had the simple task of tapping the ball home. So Worthing get us underway again. Rents looking up for Dawes, but that's over his head, over Harold's head, and for the keeper, McDonald. Time here for Maliba. Well, he eats, and somehow Crooks made something of that. And now Shelton. Campbell. Nice pass forward. And set back, and the fullback, Gabriel. He gets his cross in, and this time the deflection goes behind for a corner. Gabriel's lit lively over on that far side, and it was his cross that led to the second goal.
so Crook with the in swinger. It's Kirby free, and he got his head to it. Campbell will leave the throw for Gabriel. No, in fact, he won't. He'll take it to him. And here's Shilton. Little slide pass and a great little turn from Waleed. He gets his across. Oh, and it broke three at the back post to Parcell. And he fired wide from 6 yards. And that really should have been three. And so the first substitution for Worthing. Matt Boiling, the fullback, coming off, and Aaron Hopkinson coming on. And Shorten calmly passes it out to Gabriel over on the far side. He slows it down, turns back. And Devin. And then Kirby with a long ball forward. Ollie beaten to it in the air by Heath. Worthing can't clear their lines at the moment. Campbell gets the cross. Important header from Elphick. Again, Enfield with possession midway inside the Worthing half. Clark turned into trouble again. And Shulton. Harold. Campbell. He's got lots of time. And there, Heath with a little tug on the shirt. And there's a free kick right on the corner of the area. He fires it in. And it's in for number three! Ollie Eads siding home. And Enfield Town respond to their midweek defeat very positively here. It's a nightmare debut for goalkeeper Kieran Thorpe. He's picked the ball out of the back of it now for a third time. So Worthing need a goal and they need it quickly if they're going to try and get the most unlikeliest of comebacks. Sparks. And then Wills. Adjiboy. He hasn't seen enough of the ball for his liking for the course of this game. Maloney from Brighton. Heath has to turn back, and Wills. There's three yellow shirts being led by Shulton. Clark just gets away. Wills evades the challenge of Crooks. And there's Clark. Turns back on himself. Again, yellow shirts crowding around any attack. And that's a wasteful pass. There was two Enfield Town players in very promising positions. Now space over on this near side for Clark. He plays the ball through and doors. Is offside. And he fired his shot into the side netting anyway. Wills spreads the ball out looking for doors. He lets it go over his head, took a little touch, but Gabriel, those long legs, got there. Hodgkinson. And Rents, good shoot from here. It goes for goal and it's just high from the fullback. Worthing manager John Meaney looking on, wondering how he can inspire his team to come back from this 3-0 deficit. Campbell down the line for Gabriel. He's got time to pick out his cross. Rents half gets it away. Crooks, another cross to the back post, and another header and a good save. This time it's Parcell that was free from 6 yards. He gives a thumbs up and Thorpe prevents the score. Kind of whipped in by Crooks. Flick on header, off the post, and the rebound is blocked.
And Shelton with the ball on this down by the corner. And he wins his team a throw in. So close to a fourth. So the fullback having an eventful game, hitting the woodwork twice. Clark trying to put the pressure on McDonald. Harold then does lose out to Roger Boyd. Little drag back turn. He's got three yellow shirts around him and wins a free kick for his team. And then he reacts furiously. And it's all kicked off in the worst possible way here. And that's a red card straight away for the low knee from Brighton. You can't raise your hands. And as your boy on his home debut is going to make the long walk down the tunnel. And a second red card. And I'll be honest, I didn't see what happened, but Shelton sees his marching orders. So both teams down to 10 men. Shelton, who's arguably been. So we're about halfway into this second half. Both teams down to 10 men. Worthing down by three goals. Hopkinson gets the cross in. And it's a free header! And that's 3-1! And Dawes, with his 20th goal of the season, gets Worthing back in it. The Enfield Town players are arguing amongst themselves. Worthing are back in this game. Strong hold-up play from Ollie Eade. Wins his team a free kick. Use of the hand there, but Devin. Shot was blocked. And then a corner. It's over the head of everyone, except for Crooks, who sets it back. And a shot from distance is over the bar. And a chance for Campbell. Could have extended it to four. Got 15 minutes or so to find two goals. Wills, Dawes. And then out for Rents. And Clark made a good little run in behind there. But Crooks. And now Devin can run at Heath. And he's got a man on the outside. But Devin with a step over. Devin with a shot. And it's just gone past the upright. That will be the end of his game. And Nathan Livings will be coming on. Livings can go forward. That's a very clever run by Parcell. He slides it across. And Heath just edges Ollie Eade off. Otherwise, that surely would have been a fourth and game over. But Brodie holds the ball up on the halfway line. The ball over the top looking for Clark. Isn't going to find him. Brodie again trying to make a nuisance of himself. Crooks. And then pass out. Understandably there's space. And still, oh what a dribble, and he's gone down. And it's a free kick for a dive by Parcell. That was my initial reaction. He seemed to go over quite easily. Thank you. Marcel, shown a yellow card by the referee Jim Patterson. And now B. Montine goes back to Kirby. Campbell forward to Crook. Two red shirts go round, but that's a free kick. Wills with the foul, and Crook has stayed down. And I think he should be all right. Heath loses out. And Ollie Eads, instead of going for goal, just to eat some more clock in the corner. Crook, lovely little back heel. The shot from the corner of the area. And there's Dawes. Just rolled under his foot. He shakes his head. So Enfield Town look like they're going, marching on their playoff charge. It's well and truly back underway as the referee blows the final whistle. The two managers shake hands, which was a fairly mild-mannered game, apart from a flashpoint in the second half, which saw a player from either side getting sent off. It was Enfield Town that came into the second half with a goal lead, courtesy of a Sholton's thunderous strike. Two early goals at the start of the second half put the game seemingly beyond reach. Dawes pulled one back after the double red card incident, but Worthing never materialised with a challenge, and Enfield Town comfortably saw out the game that finished Worthing 1, Enfield Town 3. So I'm here with Worthing manager John Meaney. John, it's just didn't seem to start today for your boys. How are you feeling at this time?
Disappointed because we haven't activated and shown our true potential today. The boys have been great up until this point in the season, but on today's performance we haven't really done ourselves any great viewing, which is disappointing, and that's why we lost the game.
And coming back on a sort of disappointing midweek defeat, are you concerned that we might get another slump like we had earlier on in the season, or do you think this might just be a little blip of tiredness from the amount of games that you've played in such a short space of time?
I think obviously combination of the games that we have had, and that, but ultimately, look, we wanted to take the initiative today at home. If you can't motivate yourself to play in front of fantastic fans on a great surface, then you want shooting, really. Do you know what I mean? Ultimately, at the end of the day, we should have got something midweek. We didn't. We wanted to bounce straight back today, and unfortunately, as the game wore on, we didn't really activate our principles of play. And for me, there was some pulling and pushing in the same direction. There were others that were lacking today, and that gave us a bit of an out of balance.
Just in the incident with the red card, had your boy reacting. Have you spoken to him about that incident since?
Yeah, no, absolutely. As you boys come over and spoke to myself, Gary and Pipes, that will be the best learning curve he will probably have in his whole entire football career. You know, that won't happen again. That won't happen again for him. For his long-term player development, he will learn a lot from today, reacting to an off-the-ball situation. Combination of frustration and obviously the moment when someone does obviously deliberately make contact to you, how to respond to that, and obviously today he's done it in a negative manner, but that would be a learning curve for him, and that's what you get with young players. You know, we're a young side. The average age you look at it is 20, and like I say, you look at Omar last year, he missed 15 games from responding to players wanting to obviously look for a reaction. This year Omar sort of learnt from that, got himself a move, so I'm sure David will learn from it as well.
And one other mention I must say, he seemed to be involved in everything, was Gabriel over on the left hand side. Hit the post, hit the bar, set up one of the goals, and seemed to have legs that won every challenge when he went for the ball. What do you make of his performance today?
I thought he'd done very well, Ricky. He's been out for a little while now with, you know, wanting to play and been away with a few personal issues, and he, like you said, he's a wholehearted player. His legs seem to stretch and stretch. good energy levels. He's unlucky with the header. We said to him, try next time to keep your eyes open and probably go in with your header. But no, his link up play to get on past his winger was, you know, his energy is fantastic as well. I thought we had a very good game, very good game. We took him off towards the end just to, you know, pat him on the back and save your energy really for next week.
So important 3 points for you. Realistically, can you get yourselves, force yourselves back into the playoff picture?
I don't want to answer that question, to be honest with you, because I've been giving them that sort of answer in the last couple of games. There's some young lads in there, and you know, it's not all about pressure. If we can go on a good run now, like anyone in the league, you're in with a shout. And one game at a time, and we regroup now, we'll have a nice journey home together. It's not an easy place to come. I thought we deserved the result, but yeah, like I said, it's in our eye line, and we keep going all the way to the end.
First of all, thanks for taking time to talk to us, and good luck for the rest of the season.
Cheers, man.
Thanks, man. So that's the end of another non-league show, and we got the four goals that we promised you before the game. Unfortunately for Worthing, three of them were the back of their nets. The scoring opened a half hour, Shilton with a stunning strike from the edge of the area. And you could maybe say that Enfield maybe deserved that lead going into half-time. The midfield pairing of Crooks and Shilton certainly dominating proceedings there. Worthing, though, did have their chance in the first half. Dawes, most notably, shooting wide when it seemed like he might score. Second half, Enfield Town wrapped the game up within 12 minutes. Two goals in quick succession seemingly put the tie out of reach. Then the flash incident, two red cards, one retaliating, one reaction. Debut boy, Ajiboy, getting his marching orders, as well as the impressive Shilton. Worthing scored from that resulting free kick, and he thought that might kick in, spur on some kind of comeback. It didn't really materialise. Enfield Town held out the game and saw it through to win comfortably 3-1 at the end of this game. We'll see you next week on the Non-League Show.